Yeah, hi. Very good morning to everyone. My name is Roman Ahmed, and I am working into a data fit from last 7+ years, and I have been expertise into analytics and data science and into a data engineering. This is my second visit in MIT. As anyone has seen me before? We have a sample of cats and dogs. We will train that models, and we will see that what is the accuracy that our model has been achieved. Okay, so these are the few libraries which we need to import into a Python module. Okay, and here we are processing the image. We are reading the image from the. It is not right now visible here, but I had a folder cats and dogs, and there I had a training set, and there I have took a sample. This is the image name dog.2306.jpg, right? This is the dog image, which I can see that I have read this image, and I can show you this with the PLT. PLT is matplotlib.pypdog. Okay, this is a Python library. Okay, with the help of this, I have shown this image of the dog.
Sir, dekho sir, sahi lag
rahi. Okay, this is the image of a what hogs do, hogs basically extract the features. Okay, so basically feature extraction is a very important part into a machine learning model, because without a feature extraction, we cannot achieve that. And we need to have when you will be learning a different machine learning models. Okay, so you need to classify that what are the important features you will be using. Okay, suppose you have a 100 features in some product, okay? So you will be not going to use all these 100 features. You have to identify the correlation between the features, okay? And then on the basis of that correlation, you will be extracting the important features which has an advantages for which you will be training your machine learning, okay? So here we have did a feature extraction, and this is, see, there is a 6804 features, okay? They in this image I have extracted, there is a 6804 image.
Which is you need to extract only those features. Kya aap example de sakte ho, iska matlab kya hoga? Humne kal kaafi baar discuss kiya hai, machine learning ko perform karne ke liye we need a data, right? Okay, we need a huge data, right? But we need a relevant data. Why? Can you give me one example of any domain? Like we have given the example of population. आप नेहा मैम को बताओ कि हम अगर डेटा लेते हैं पॉपुलेशन प्रेडिक्ट करना है तो व्हाई वी चूज द डेटा रिलेवेंट, मेक द सेशन इंटरैक्टिव. इफ यू वोट, अगर आप भी आज भी नहीं बोलोगे तो अगेन फिर नहीं आएगा.
आई अज्यूम दैट कि यू नो ऑल दिस थिंग्स, ओके? बिकॉज मीन्स आई फिर पढ़ा है, नहीं पढ़ा है, इट्स ओके. वी आर हियर टू एक्सप्लेन यू गाइस, राइट? फीचर एक्सेप्शन आप मेरे ख्याल से कल प्रवीण ने एक्सप्लेन कर रखा है. फीचर्स क्या होते हैं बताओ ना. फीचर्स क्या होते हैं, फीचर्स क्या होते हैं?
अच्छा सिर्फ इतना बता दो कि अगर पॉपुलेशन प्रेडिक्ट करना है हमें, तो व्हाट आर द डेटा इज रेलेवेंट और व्हाट आर द डेटा इज इररेलेवेंट.
सपोज शूट विद आवर सेल्फ ऑन दैट ईयर ये इस इलेवन डे का हो जाएगा क्योंकि इससे पॉपुलेशन का कोई लेना देना नहीं है.
जस्ट टेक एन एग्जाम्पल, इस क्लास में एनिमल्स भी हैं, ह्यूमंस भी हैं, राइट? एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो ह्यूमंस कौन से हैं और एनिमल्स कौन से हैं, ठीक है, तो ऑन व्हाट बेसिस यू विल आइडेंटिफाई दैट दिस आर ह्यूमंस एंड दिस आर एनिमल्स? फेशियल रिकॉग्निशन फीचर्स बेसिकली. सो ह्यूमंस हैव अ डिफरेंट फीचर्स, राइट, एंड एनिमल्स हैव डिफरेंट फीचर्स, एवरीबॉडी नोज. So on the basis of features only you can analyze that this is a I will be giving you a different product, means these are, means I am telling you that is identify is it a human or is it a animal. So on the basis of what you can be identifying on the basis of the feature, right? So this is one feature extraction. You are extracting, means you know that humans have a legs and hands, okay, they have a hairs and on a certain portion they have a different shape, right? So on all these other features you will be identifying what are the important features on the basis of which you can identify that these are humans and these are animals, right guys? Getting it? So this is one of feature extraction. So here we have got a certain features. Now this is a training data set, okay, so I'm not going to elaborate more, but I will be, there is, I have an empty list here. So what I am basically doing it here, so I am, this is a globe library, okay, which I am extracting a data from this images, means this is a star.jpg. It means that I am taking all the images. So there is a list here, I have a docs folder, and in that all the photos, all the images I am extracting, okay, and it is coming one by one into an entry. And then I am reading it, so I am getting, so here I am getting a color image, I am reading an image here, okay, so I am getting here a color image, okay, so color image is having more number of features as compared to the black and white photos, right? So what I have did here, so I have converted into a gray images, right, I have converted into a black, there is a channel access is equal to -1, so this is basically a one of the parameters which you can pass, okay, then I have appended, you know append function, you know append, so I have appended all the images, same with the cat images, okay, I have trained, these are the trained data, okay, now, so I have 800, so I have what I have treated, I have concatenated it, now I am getting total 800 images, okay, 400 of cats and 400 of dogs, these are the trained data, okay, now, what I am basically labeling it here, okay, so I am labeling the dogs, so this is what you will be getting, 400 cat here and 400 dogs here, and their total count is 800, right guys? So I am now labeling it, okay, so supervised learning is basically you know the outcome, okay, on the basis of outcome you can say that okay this is dog or this is the cat, okay, so you have labeled here, we have labeled the same library here, means the same process has been done here, it is just I have created a dictionary where I have key data, I am extracting all the features, and in label I am labeling it as a dog, and same here I am making another dictionary, and in this I have labeling all the cat data into this, okay, so now I will concatenate it, so this is my test data basically, so I'm testing 50 dogs and 50 cats images, right? I will provide this code as well to you guys, okay, do not worry about it, okay, so see here, right now I'm getting total count as 100, this is a test data basically, and 50 dog and 50 cat will be here, okay, now KNN implementations come here, KNN is K nearest neighbors algorithm basically, it's one of the algorithm of a supervised learning, there are many modes, there is the basically we ideally use, there are three types of machine learning, okay, so you guys can tell me, yaar tum logo ko pata hai to aisa lag raha hai ki kisi ko pata hi nahi,
three types
kaun kaun sa hota hai, tell me, raise your hand guys, कौन बता रहा है? एनीवन? यहां से कोई? सेकंड ईयर? ब्लैंक पेज? सेकंड ईयर बताओ. अच्छा कल नहीं थे? अच्छा कोई नहीं. कोई यार यहां से या फाइनल ईयर में तो उसको तो पता ऑब्वियस है, बट आई वांट एन आंसर फ्रॉम सेकंड ईयर. इट्स ओके बताओ.
फर्स्ट ईयर वालों को
सुपरवाइज मशीन लर्निंग अनसुपरवाइज पता नहीं क्या रीइंफोर्समेंट टाइप मशीन लर्निंग.
सुपरवाइज क्या होता है?
सुपरवाइज्ड इज व्हेन वी गिव लेबल्ड डेटा लाइक वी टीच समवन लाइक दैट्स सुपरवाइज्ड बिकॉज़ वी आर टीचिंग देम अंडर सुपरविजन सो दैट्स सुपरवाइज्ड डेटा. Unsupervised is, I think, finding patterns on its own. Like, we have not labeled the data any kind of. So, we are not teaching it, but it's like finding the pattern on its own.
And reinforcement?
Reinforcement is based on feedback. Like, if we, like, feedback-based learning. Like, when we tell a child that you will get a chocolate if you, like, do it right. Like, we tell a way. So, that's, like, reinforcement.
वेरी गुड यार, एक बार जोर से क्लैप कर दो यार इसके लिए. वेरी गुड. व्हाट इज योर नेम गाइस? प्रकर. वेरी गुड यार प्रकर. यार
यार लाल.
सो मींस यू विल कम अक्रॉस दीज वर्ड्स. ओके सो लेट्स बेटर अंडरस्टैंड राइट नाउ. ओके बिकॉज व्हेन यू विल गो इन इंडस्ट्री, ओके दीज आर द मोस्ट कॉमनली वर्ड यू विल बी यूजिंग एंड दिस एल्गोरिथम इज लाइक will be a day-to-day life. Means we deal on a daily basis such algorithm, okay? To basically I work into a fintech, okay? And we basically design a CPD platforms and you get some lot of offer, right? On a different banks, okay? So there is a machine learning running behind it, okay? There is customer segmentations, there are a lot of things you get an offer on the basis of that. That's a part of machine learning, right? So means it is important. So let's come here. So there is means we will be doing this Euclidean training and there is a one more Manhattan training, okay? So there is a means I am analyzing, means what I have did, I have trained our model into Euclidean training and Manhattan training and I have analyzed what is the accuracy, means we will see, means if we are predicting it anyone, so no model give you 100% prediction, okay, nobody, okay, even humans cannot predict, so this is a machine and so basically this first I am explaining you a Euclidean training and then I will be giving you a Manhattan training, okay? So what Euclidean training is giving basically, it's a class, KNN is basically you have to, it's a classifier basically, okay? So there is a classifier data, train data, okay? On the basis of this you will be finding this certain parameters, okay? And then there is a prediction, okay? You will be predicting here and there will be an accuracy. What is the accuracy of your data, okay? On the basis of what? On the basis of train and? On the basis of train and?
Test
data. Perfect. Okay? Then there is a confusion matrix and then all those things you will be scoring. You will be, there is a F1 score basically there. Okay? So there you will be analyzing here F1 score and you, so I want to show them a score. So this is a Manhattan training. So this both is having the same parameters and there is a one only difference into a Manhattan training and to a Euclidean training that I am identifying giving a p is equal to 1, that is the only one difference. Rest will be the same KNN Manhattan, okay, and I am also here finding an accuracy with a Manhattan also and I am also calculated accuracy with Euclidean as well. So here I will be finding a score. So this is the basically Manhattan score. So this is the confusion matrix, this is the score, this is the accuracy percentage, okay. So this is for k from 1 to 10, 7, okay. I am considering k is equal to 1, so I have told you that K is a number of neighbors. Okay? So what basically KNN do? Suppose there is a 2 point. There is a 1 point having a point A and B, having a means index A comma B, and there is another point, suppose X comma Y. So how you will be finding a distance between two point? Simple, A minus X ka whole square plus B minus Y ka whole square under root mein, square root. Okay, this is how you will be finding a distance. So, यहाँ पे भी सेम होता है, ठीक है? KNN क्या करता है कि आपके नेबर्स में देखता है कि यार आपके इन एंड अराउंड का क्या मॉडल्स जो है वो किस तरीके का डेटा है, ऑन द बेस फीचर्स किस किस तरीके के हैं, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट वो आपको प्रिडिक्ट करके देता है डेटा. Getting it? So, I have drawn a plot as well, graph as well. This is a score of now. This is a score of I can say Euclidean, and now this is the graph. Okay. So this is the F1 scores. Okay. So this is, you can see this Manhattan graph, and this is an Euclidean graph. Okay. With the numbers of K as increases, the accuracy has been declined. Okay, can you see that? As you have increased the number of K, the accuracy has been declined. This is the conclusion we can make from this graph. Okay, what is the insight? If I will say that, what is the insight of this graph? What is the conclusion? So that is the only thing. With an increase, with as the number of the K has been increased, the accuracy has been declined. The score has been declined in this graph, and accuracy is also declined. Okay, so this is the second graph with respect to accuracy, with respect to score. So this is a KNN, simple KNN model which I have designed for you guys. Okay, to better understand what is feature extraction, what is features, what is the machine learning algorithm. There are lots of algorithm. Okay, you can learn. Okay, so now moving towards our main topic, what is an application of machine learning in UAE? Right. So do you guys have any question? This is a simple algorithm. This is a means KNN algorithm. Okay. Application of machine learning with UAV. Okay. So as we have seen in last 5 to 7 years, there is a lot of use of drones. Okay, so means people are, means industry has been, means government also have a several scheme towards a drone, right? They have a certain policies towards a drone as well, that nobody can means access drone easily as well. You need to get a certification to fly your drone as well, right? There are so many government has provided so many schemes as well. They have incentivized the policies as well for a drone as well. And last 5 years, the drone industry has been increased, and it is estimated that it will increase by 70% by 2050. Right? So why this is, means why government is focusing on this drone system, and why means they are again giving an incentives, subsidizing this drone system, why? Anyone? From BC? Electronics and communication student? Make some noise. You need Bansa to make some noise? Nobody from EC? EC branch? Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? EC? No. EC? So, how are you? Why are you not understanding what you are saying? What is it? Why is the drones ka demand itna zyada increase hua hai? Kya reason hai?
Sir, unregistered, जो एरिया होते जहाँ ह्यूमन नहीं जा सकते हैं, वहाँ पर सर ये ड्रोन जाकर हमारी मदद पहुंचाती है, उसके लिए ड्रोन की जरूरत पड़ी। और लाइक सर ने एग्जाम्पल दिया था कहीं फ्रॉड आया था, तो फ्रॉड में सर X91 मदद भी की थी। जिस टाइम पर सर वहाँ पर सर नेटवर्क की प्रॉब्लम हो रही थी, जिस टाइम पर उन्होंने उस ड्रोन की मदद से बहुत सारी मेडिसिन को पहुंचाई थी, और उसमें बहुत ही नए अपग्रेड के बारे में बताया था कि ड्रोन को आने वाले दिन में ड्रोन को फ्लाई करने के लिए भी हमें कुछ जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी। तो उस टाइम पर सर वहाँ पर AI की सर मशीन लर्निंग के थ्रू उसमें सर AI भी इंक्लूड हो चुका है, उसमें ये फीचर आ चुकी है कि ड्रोन खुद से वो उसको टास्क देने के पर्टिकुलर काम को करके वापस भी आ सकता है। लाइक सर उसमें फ्लाइंग करने टाइम वेदर को भी डिटेक्ट कर सकता है, ग्राउंड एरिया को मैपिंग कर सकता है सर, और फॉरेस्ट में जाकर एनिमल को आने वाले दिन में वहां पर से जाकर एनिमल काउंटिंग एक्स्ट्रा या फिर डीजे को डिटेक्ट करना, ये सारी चीज काम कर सकता और कर भी रहा है सर। उस सब के लिए ड्रोन की सर बहुत अच्छी डिमांड हुई, और सर कम पैसा में सर उसमें ड्रोन को कम से कम टाइम में कर सकते हैं। और थैंक यू सर। और सर
लैंग्वेज नॉट अ बैरियर, अगर आपको हिंदी में कंफर्टेबल हो तो आप बता सकते हो, मतलब मैं नहीं कह रहा हूँ, मतलब इंग्लिश तो मुझे लगता है सभी को आता होगा, लेकिन इफ सम पीपल फील दैट कि मुझे हिंदी में बताना है तो यार बता सकते हो, बट मुझे लगता है कि यहाँ पे लोगों को पता है बट दे आर हेजिटेटिंग, राइट? दिस इज द ओनली थिंग। तुम लोग सर यही हो रहा है कि पता तो है ऐसा लेकिन मैं बताना नहीं चाहती हूँ, राइट?
तो बना दिया और नहीं है, सो दिस इज रेलिवेंट टू यू व्हाट यू हैव हेड, तो मैम इसको आप एज अ प्रोजेक्ट ले सकते हैं। तो हमने 9 प्रोजेक्ट निकाले हैं जो आपको ड्रोन दिया जा रहा है, उसी से आप ये 9 प्रोजेक्ट इंप्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं, ठीक है? तो इट डिपेंड अपॉन यू, क्योंकि हम सर्वर बेसिकली हम मॉडल भी दे रहे हैं, सर्वर भी दे रहे हैं, और जो आपको कोड रुमान ने दिखाया दैट कोड इज ऑलरेडी वही यूज होगा सारे के सारे प्रोजेक्ट के लिए। तो दीज आर द 9 प्रोजेक्ट विच इज बेस्ड ऑन ड्रोन प्लस इमेजेस, और इटसेल्फ जो ड्रोन दिया जाएगा उसी से हो जाएगा। तो लेट्स सी वन बाय वन, और उसके ऊपर रुमान ने वीडियो भी लेके आए हैं कि कौन से वीडियो किस तरीके से क्लासिफाई है और इसको यूज कर सकते हो। लेट्स सी वन बाय वन।
ओके, सो ऑब्जेक्ट डिटेक्शन UAV से, तो मेरे ख्याल से अभी हमने वर्कशॉप किया है 4 दिन में, तो ऑब्जेक्ट डिटेक्शन के बारे में पढ़ा होगा, तो मीन्स वे आई विल नॉट इन्वेस्टिंग टाइम हियर, आई विल बी जस्ट गोइंग थ्रू वीडियोस, सो आई हैव फिगर आउट वन वीडियोस फॉर यू फॉर एन ऑब्जेक्ट डिटेक्शन विद द हेल्प ऑफ UAV, ठीक है? सो व्हाट इज एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग, ओके?
नाक साफ करता है भाई, तो बोल रहा था
नाक साफ करता है
नीचे वाली सीढ़ी पे खड़ा हो, बिल्कुल तेरा चेहरा दिखेगा इसमें।
ओके यार, वीडियो तो